Mr. President, my good friend, Congressman Steny Hoyer, promotes America by using the phrase, make it in America. It talks about the pride of our country, the ingenuity, the spirit of American workers, and the fact that we can compete against any country in the world on a level playing field. We can make it in America. I rise today to share with my fellow senators news of my recent visit to Maryland businesses who are contributing to our local and national economy through manufacturing innovation. As part of what I call Made in Maryland tour, I visited the Volvo Group North America's manufacturing facility in Hagerstown, Maryland, and the Flying Dog Brewery in Frederick, Maryland. Just a few weeks ago, I toured the Paul Reed Smith Guitar Factory on the Eastern Shore. My Made in Maryland tour has highlighted many of the leading job creators and key small businesses that have helped revive Maryland's manufacturing sector. The goal is to meet with employees and business owners, take stock of their challenges and successes, and help them identify ways that the federal government can help them grow and innovate. We've highlighted the diverse products being produced in our great state, and we are celebrating the hardworking Marylanders who have made these products and the companies who are providing jobs in our local communities. For example, the Paul Reed Smith Guitar Factory in Stevensonville, Maryland, makes high-end guitars used by some of the most prominent musicians in the world, including Carlos Santana. Operating for nearly 30 years, the Paul Reed Smith now employs 230 workers with revenues of $24 million. This is the largest private employer in Queen Anne's County, Maryland, and one of the top five private employers on the Upper Shore. As a region and as a country, we must stay focused on creating good jobs at home and strengthen and continue to build our economy. Manufacturing is good for Maryland, and it's good for America. Let me tell you about my visit to Volvo Group, which employs 1,500 people in Hagerstown, Maryland, accounting for one out of every 10 jobs in the region's manufacturing sector. Employees at this facility are paid approximately 62% above the average wage in the region. These are good jobs, jobs that people are proud to hold. Volvo has set the standard for environmentally aware manufacturing. Through its partnership with the U.S. Department of Energy, Volvo has developed the next generation of fuel-efficient engines and trucks. Since 2001, Volvo has invested $330 million to upgrade and renovate their facilities, allowing Volvo to build a state-of-the-art engine development laboratory to produce increasingly fuel-efficient engines. This Volvo facility has shown outstanding success. 60 of Volvo's trucks today emit the same emission as one truck in 1990. That's an amazing reduction of pollutants going into the air. In addition, the facility recycles 84% of the site's waste, and it has achieved an 83% decrease in the use of diesel fuels. Furthermore, Volvo remains invested in Western Maryland by making generous contributions to local health and welfare organizations, civic and community organizations, art and cultural organizations, and education initiatives across the region. This commitment to the well-being of Volvo employees is demonstrated by the August 2013 opening of an on-site family-first pharmacy, which will provide employees and their families with innovative state-of-the-art health care to be provided by doctors, nurses, and pharmacists in cooperation with Walgreens. As the Volvo facility is highly invested in the local community and its numerous employees, we must remain invested in ensuring this socially responsible company future success. Later in the day, I traveled to Frederick, Maryland, and the Flying Dog Brewery. They make a very different product than the most energy-efficient transmissions in the world that are assembled at Volvo, but I recognize the same qualities in both these unique companies and their employees. Hard work, attention to detail, and a real pride in and passion for the product being made. These are qualities that can never be outsourced. Small breweries like Flying Dog have been anchors of local economies and American economy since the start of our history. This is the state-of-the-art facility that constantly works to perfect its product through innovative techniques. In addition to making a product whose high quality I can attest to, they're supporting 80 jobs and reinvesting profits back into Western Maryland community. When I grew up, brewing in Maryland was a huge industry. We lost most of it, but it's coming back. Today, the brewing industry in Maryland is supporting more than $13 million in wages paid and are contributing nearly $100 million to our state economy. My Made in Maryland tour was conceived to highlight manufacturing and innovation that is boosting our economy across our state. But I can tell you that agriculture, which is still our number one industry, is being revived along the way too. During my tour of the Flying Dog Brewery, I met a farmer and his son who are fifth and sixth generation Frederick County family farmers, celebrating 175th year of their family farm. They told me that their decision to begin growing barley, small grains, and hops for local breweries is what kept their family going. They supply small grains and hops to Flying Dog and numerous Maryland brewing companies for many of their seasonal, locally brewed beers. Amber Fields Malting and Brewing Company, in conjunction with Brewers Alley Restaurant and Brewery in Frederick, Maryland, introduced Amber Fields Best Bitter, which they describe as an English-style best bitter. This was the first commercially brewed beer in over 100 years to rely exclusively on barley grown and malted in Maryland. Amber Fields Best Bitter and additional releases also feature locally grown ingredients are available through Brewer Alley and their sister breweries, Monocacy Brewing Company, both in Frederick, Maryland. America's manufacturing sector, from autos and truck manufacturing to beer makers and guitars, have played a major role in growing our economy and our nation to be the world's leader, and has also helped create the strongest middle class in history. To continue in our recovery, we need to make sure companies like Volvo Group, Flying Dog Brewery, and Paul Reed Smith Guitars, who are creating jobs and investing in our community here at home, have what they need to be successful. Our job in Washington should be to make their job easier, because when they do better, we all do better.